And welcome back to Burgess Snowfield. Tommy went along with Mickey Shadricks. We're getting set for another matchup. Should be a great one here. Munford taking on Paul W. Bryant. And you look at Paul Bryant, they've just finished a win here. And that's something that has been rare for that program. I saw a team out here today that had a lot of confidence. They really performed well.
You know, I talked to Paul Bryant's head coach during the rain delay, and he was, you know, just like all the teams who were here and waiting this out and wondering what was going to happen. He was very discouraged. You know, we travel all the way over here, kids excited about playing. And I saw him down on the field just a moment ago. He's a totally different attitude now. He's excited. His team played well in that quarter against Center Point and got a touchdown on the board. And now they get a chance to test themselves against a good Mumford team, a team that's very well established, got a new coach. Will Wagner has moved on. But still, Mumford's got a lot of talent returning and be a good matchup.
Really do. And the one thing that I saw out of Paul Bryant in the first matchup a few moments ago was energy. I was able to be down the sideline when they got started. They were excited to be here, excited to take part. That's coming off of a season that was 1-9. So really something positive. Let's see if it carries over against this Mumford Lion team. And again, a new coach at Mumford. He's really instilled a new look as we take a look at the new uniforms and such as that. This is going to be a new look Mumford team. And kind of excited to see what takes place for this Lion program.
Yeah, it's ironic. Mumford's got, I guess that's kind of a gray look to the pants. And you and I were joking during the break. I guess maybe they're trying to get away from the Will Wagner red pants, so they've got more of a gray look. But just kidding there. But yeah, it's looking at Mumford just with the eye test, Tommy, mm-hmm. down underneath the stands during the weather delay. They look like they are ready to reload and go at it again. They've got a lot of numbers out once again. They have some really good-looking athletes. They have some size to go up front in both the offensive and defensive lines. And that's really what's really put Mumford back on the map, in my view, is they've always had skill players, but they've got those big guys up front on both sides of the line of scrimmage that has really made them a factor on the high school football scene the last few years.
They really have, and they've been able to play players only one way, and that's something that's really huge when you're talking about Class 4A, and they continue to improve. They built a great program here. Will Wagner did not leave the cupboard bare. No. There's going to be some talent on the field tonight, and I'm excited to take a look at this new look Mumford team.
Yeah, and it's kind of a contrast in styles, too, and two teams that are not that familiar with each other, obviously, and in this little round robin format that we're experiencing right now between Center Point, Mumford, and Paul Bryant.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll get set. Mumford and again, Paul W. Bryant doing battle for a quarter. This is the Gridiron Challenge right here on TV 24. You're looking at Burgess Snowfield here at Jacksonville State University. Again, we had a downpour a little bit earlier, and that's good news about having the turf such as we have here, Mickey. You're looking at the field that in about 5 minutes you're playing just like you were before the rain. And I tell you, I had a chance to walk down there on the field a little bit earlier, and the field in great shape. And we really appreciate the folks at Jacksonville State for allowing us to be able to use the facilities here today, and this has been a great event for a lot of these schools, and had a chance to talk to some of the folks from Randolph County with just so excited about the opportunity to play at a stadium and a venue such as this.
Yeah, really, it's been a great day, Tommy. We've seen, hopefully we'll be able to get all of the rest of the games in, and it'll be 22 teams, 13 games throughout the day here. And we're into the nighttime portion of the schedule, obviously, and kind of very excited to see this Mumford team. Again, a new head coach in Bill Smith. Definitely got a lot of coaching pedigree coming into Mumford, a very impressive resume. I guess if you're going to lose a guy like Will Wagner, you want to replace him with a guy like Bill Smith. So be interesting to see. I know it's just a spring game. They haven't had much time with their new coach. But it's going to be good to see what this Mumford team, a little snapshot of what they're going to look like in this new era with Bill Smith.
Yeah, you talk about Smith, his first season coming up at Mumford, former head coach at Shades Valley and Crossville, played collegiately at Alabama, and he brings a new excitement. I know that talking to some folks in Mumford, he has really come in and adopted the community. They've adopted him. They said you could be at a T-ball game on a Tuesday night, and Bill Smith is there just wanting to meet the people of Mumford, and has really, really made his mark on the community.
And I'll tell you a story that I can relay now. I haven't really said this publicly till now. I just remember this. about 2 weeks before he was officially named as the head coach, I get a text from a number I didn't recognize, mm-hmm. and it was Bill Smith.
Right.
He said, "Mickey, this is Bill Smith. I want to make sure that we still have our place in the Gridiron Challenge."
Wow.
I'm the new coach at Mumford will be named soon.
Wow.
And that tells you how much this event has already, as we get a look at him here in the pregame, he's already in his game mode here. Mm-hmm. But that tells you how much he had already heard about this event and how much he wanted to have his team in this event.
And I know that I got here early this morning, and my first walk around the stadium, and someone said, "There's the new Mumford coach." And this was about 11 o'clock this morning. So he has been a part of this throughout the day today. His team comes in tonight, and as you can see there, he's a high-energy guy. Going to be, again, that's something that's not going to change from the Wagnon era, because you talk about energy. Wagnon had it, and now, again, Bill Smith's going to bring it to this Lion program as well.
And the job he did at Shades Valley under tough circumstances really says a lot about the quality of this type of coach. And I know the Mumford administration, the Mumford community, very excited. Again, they didn't want to lose Will Wagnon, because right. Will Wagnon had brought a lot of swagger, if you will, back to that Mumford football program that is so rich in tradition. But they are very excited about who's leading their football program. And, you know, you could say the same thing about Paul Bryant. They've definitely gone through their coaches as well. The five head coaches in the 13-year school history. Eldrick Hill, their coach now, is a fourth Stampede head coach in 6 years. And he's a high-energy guy and very emotional. And, speaking to him during the weather delay, he was – very hopeful that his team would be able to get out here and play, and it's looking very much like, with him having back-to-back quarters here, it looks like his team's going to get in their time here at the Gridiron Challenge, and they got about a two-hour drive back home, so it'll be a late night for them.
The officials were saying when the clock hit triple zeros, they were going to snap the football. Mumford still warming up to our right. They will now scamper to the sideline, and Paul Bryant is basically ready to snap the football. And I'll tell you what, for Paul Bryan in that first, Reed Snyder, the junior quarterback, looked very good. 5'11", 164. And you're talking about a young man there that has excellent zip on throwing the football and did a tremendous job there in the first. And also Zabrian Moore, the wide receiver, had a big touchdown catch. And he was a weapon on the outside. So if you get the football to number one, some great things have happened for Paul Bryan here in the early going. Mumford still taking a break as they will now come out defensively to open up this ball game. Paul Bryant going to start at the 30-yard line as we'll try to run down some of our keys to this ball game, some of the key performers for both schools. But again, I think it starts with Reed Snyder. Had an excellent start, and this will be the second go-around after that exciting first period that they had. Snyder takes the shotgun snap, gives it off up the middle. A gain out to about the 33, maybe the 34-yard line. On the carry for Bryant is Raylan Crooks, a junior running back. Stampede go with no huddle. And Snyder looks to the sideline. Mumford in a 3-4 defense. They'll move a lot of defenders around. Now five-man linebacker core. And they'll bring everybody. Snyder hands it off. This time, nothing doing on the left side. Crooks unable to get anything going, brings up third down. Third, we'll call it about 6 yards to go for the Stampede. A couple of basic plays there against this Mumford defense. Austin Stevens back for his senior year at linebacker. I'm going to tell you, it's hard pressed to find a better linebacker in this part of the state. Snyder going to throw it deep. Got his man down there, and they can't connect. Looking deep for Moore once again. Moore had a step. Overthrows him by about a yard. But I'll tell you what, that proves to you right there, Reed Snyder's got a strong arm, just unloads and chunks it down the field. And fortunately for the Lions, Moore unable to run under it.
Yeah, that was just a flat go route there. And Moore showing his sprinter speed there going down the far sideline, just simply overthrown ball.
Mumford football, as they hold three and out, will take over at their 35-yard line. Again, in this matchup, only one period of play of 15 minutes. We're at the 13:38 mark. And Munford takes over offensively. Shotgun formation for the Lions. Three wideouts to the near side. Carry on the right side. Not a whole lot there. We have a number four on the carry playing quarterback. We do not have a number four listed on our roster. And that will be a gain of about a half yard. Second down and long. You might need the quarterback's name and number. That's always helpful,
isn't it? Absolutely hate it when this happens. You know, this has been spring football. These coaches have had so few times together, and when you're trying to gather information for 22 teams, it can be a challenge, and sometimes you run into things like this. So hopefully we can track down the name of number four. Especially if he's going to be handling the ball every time, Tommy.
Passes on the outside. It's low. Intended out here for Elston. Cannot connect with him. It's going to bring up third down about nine. Another element to not having the number could be the new uniforms.
Yeah.
As maybe his number didn't come in, so he had to take a number four. But as we take a look, we will try to run down that number four. 12:33 left here in the first period. A couple of wideouts either side for the Lions. Rolling to the near side. Floats a pass up there. It's up for grabs. Almost intercepted. Coverage out here by the Stampede. Brian Moore able to knock it away. Had a chance to pick it off, but it will be knocked out. And it'll be three and out now for the Lions.
Boy, this was a big mistake to try to throw this rolling out to his left against his body. And boy, Moore should have picked that off. Avery Harris is number four. We just get that name confirmed for us. So Harris will learn from that one, I'm sure, when they break down the film. Coach Smith will point out to his quarterback that he should have just either ran that or thrown that one away.
Turn it over on downs, back to the Stampede. They all start at their own 34-yard line, first down and 10. Reed Snyder back in at quarterback, steps back, throws it into flats. It's a bullet out here. It's caught across the 40-yard line to the 42, maybe the 43-yard line. Will go Spencer. Good catch on first down. Picks up about 8 yards. Brings up a second down and two. I tell you what, Snyder delivers a great football in a hurry. And you see right here the Munford defense swarming defensively. But that's Spencer refusing to go down. He'll pick up 8 yards, so second down and short for the Stampede. Movement on the interior, and I believe a couple of defenders entered the neutral zone. That will cost Munford 5 and will be an automatic first down for Paul W. Bryant.
Yeah, hard count. Got him. 5 yards. They'll get the first down the easy way.
Moves it forward to the 47-yard line. Again, the spread looks shotgun formation. Reed Snyder, 5'11", 164. Strong arm quarterback for Paul W. Bryant. First down at 10. He'll take a step back. Again, this quick hitch on the outside across the 45-yard line and down to the Munford 44-yard line. On the reception again is Spencer. Just about an 8-yard stop route.
You know, when Snyder throws it, I almost get the impression he's on the mound and he's winding up and turning it loose. I don't know if this young man plays baseball, but kind of has that look to it.
Yeah, you look at the key players for the Stampede. Snyder, of course, the junior quarterback. Spencer on the outside. We've seen a couple of catches there, and Moore with a touchdown catch in the first period. Those are some offensive weapons for the Stampede, but it really is. I think it delivers it like a baseball throw, and he is throwing fastballs, not changeups, to the outside, and he is able to find Spencer on a couple of occasions. On for the first down that time was Crooks. So the Stampede with a fresh set of downs with 9:43 left here in this period. Snyder, shotgun, got it, leaves it with Crooks. He's hit at the line. Good stop in there, Austin Stevens. He is a tackling machine. Back-to-back years with over 100 stops for that inside linebacker.
You know, you hear defensive coaches talk about we've got to fit the run. We've got to fit better. That's how you fit right there, number 14, Austin Stevens. That's about as good a fit as you can see.
Has a nose for the football. Flip on the outside. Chance for some big yardage here. Down the far sideline. Gain of about 12 to the 30-yard line. And butted out of bounds to the 29-yard line. Good catch and run. Just a screen to the outside. Good blocking downfield. And finally being knocked out of bounds. Good for another first down for Paul W. Bryant. First down and 10 at the 29-yard line. Split outs. Three will come to the near side. One to the top of the screen. That is Zabrian Moore. As Snyder will set play here. Takes the snap, drops back down the middle, actually to the far side to Moore. Got a step and got a touchdown. Again, Zabrian Moore showing that great speed. Gets a step on the defender. Excellent thrown pass from Reed Snyder. You see right here, excellent thrown pass, perfectly on the numbers. And Moore goes in for six to take a 6-0 lead for the Stampede.
Yeah, he didn't overthrow him that time, Tommy. Snyder led him perfectly as Moore got behind the defensive back. And that was just a beautiful throw and catch for Paul Bryant as they jump ahead of Mumford here.
Receivers all over the field once again. Snyder, fade pattern, near side. Coverage is there, going to be incomplete. 6-0, intended for Lance Ford over here on the near side. 8:25 remaining here in this period. Paul W. Bryant takes a 6-0 lead. We got a flag on the two-point conversion down here on the near sideline. And Mickey, you and I were talking before this game. Paul Bryant's coach, Eldrick Hill, talked about college recruiters being here to see a couple of players. I'm going to think that number one might be a college recruiter's contact. That would be one that I would be looking at. This guy's got great size, 6'2", 165, and excellent speed on the outside.
It is definitely one of the two prospects that Coach Hill was expecting some college recruiters here to check out tonight. He's a good player.
Taking a look at the Talladega Ford scoring drive, 7 plays, 66 yards, eating 3.5 minutes off the clock. It ends with a touchdown pass from Snyder to Zabrian Moore. Mumford offensively, off to a tough start, first drive, 3 and out. Back in there at quarterback is Harris. He'll give it off right side, not a lot of room, and being slammed down is Charles Smith. Nowhere to run, brings up 2nd down and 10. Paul Bryant defensively able to get a lot of penetration here early.
Won the battle at the line of scrimmage that time. Paul Bryant got some good size on that defensive front, giving that Mumford offensive line all they can handle.
Avery Harris back to pass. Going to look down the middle now. Flip it on the outside. Catch is made for the first down and more. 40-yard line, 45. Driving defenders across the 45 and all the way out to the 47-yard line for the Mumford Lions. And that is the number 23, QT Elston, the senior. Good look there at Eldrick Hill, 1-9 in his first season. Second season at Paul Bryant, 5 head coaches in 13 years. He wants to bring some stability to this program. And tell you what, he is a high-energy coach. Handoff up the middle this time on the carry. It is Smith and Mumford with a little offensive movement of their own across the 45 and down to the 43-yard line. Shy of the first down by about a half yard.
Yeah, Mumford kind of needed to get something going offensively, get in a little bit of rhythm, and that pass that they just completed a moment ago seems to have energized their offense here.
Avery Harris again, the quarterback, takes the shotgun snap, fakes the handoff. Now he's going to keep it, got a little gap, breaks it to the far side, 35-yard line, Harris, 30, 25, 20-yard line. He'll take it down to about the 19. Avery Harris, his first carry of the ball game. Excellent read. He saw the defenders going with the flow, cuts it back, finds a gap, and he's got speed to burn and a huge gain for this Mumford Lion offense. And they've got a first down and 10 inside the 20-yard line at about the 19.
And we've got an injured Paul Bryant player down on the field, which is what you do not want to see in a spring game. It looks like it's a left leg injury of some type, maybe a cramp, who knows.
Yeah, it's a humid day, and again, when you're playing back-to-back here, maybe that's going to be the effect here on that Paul Bryant player. They're checking him out across the way, moving pretty good, as you see there. A lot of football here this Saturday, as we have had a busy day, and more to come. We still have the matchup in just a few moments between Mumford and Centerpoint. That will be the next period, and then after that we'll close out with two periods between Spring Garden and Randolph County. So talking about Randolph County. I had a chance to visit with some of the fans during that break a little bit earlier, and really 3 days of spring practice, and they're here.
Wow.
Some of the baseball players had one day, and now they're here. So a lot of these players, Coach Pat Prestridge does double duty at Randolph County, coaching the baseball team. They played for the state championship earlier this week. So they were in Montgomery, and a lot of the baseball players on the team obviously couldn't be practicing for football. And the assistants, as someone said, we did the best we could. We'll see how it looks tonight. But not a lot of practice time, especially with your head coach having to pull that double duty. So. But the Tigers, deep tradition, so they'll come out here ready to play a little bit later on. As you see the injured player there trying to help him off. And as we said, hopefully just some cramps as he will exit the field. Paul Bryant, that is number 20, Dorian Brooks. He is a sophomore as he will check out.
And not able to put any weight whatsoever on that left leg. And he's wearing some type of brace there on both knees, and they were working on that left knee, so we only hope that it's not some type of knee injury.
You see him coming off there with a lot of assistance. Munford offensively starting to move the football. First down and 10, just inside the 20. Harris to Smith. Smith trying to bounce it outside, and he's going to be brought down. Good pursuit by Brandon Benderson, the linebacker. 5'11", 227, sophomore, as he will bring down Smith there. Gain of only a yard, brings up second and 9.
Four down territory for Mumford, no doubt about it. This clock is winding, 6.5 to play in the quarter. Mumford got to get some points on the board.
Harris again with a shotgun look, three receivers to the near side. Harris back to pass, throws a slant and cannot connect. Austin Campbell was open. Harris could not get it to him, just off the fingertips. As Harris delivers a bullet, but not able to pull it in is Campbell. It's going to bring up third down at about 9.
Got to make that catch. A little bit out in front of Campbell, but he could get his hands on it. And got to help your quarterback out in that kind of situation. Now a third and long coming up now for the Lions.
Third down at about 9. Harris, the quarterback, three wideouts, will come to the near side. Takes the snap, rolls right side, in trouble, breaks one tackle, and will hammer his way down to about the 13-yard line. But it's going to bring up a fourth down, and we'll call it about 4 to go for this Lion offense. And
Tommy, this is
like
a
jumbo package coming in, looks like.
Yeah, this is a big play because they may not get the ball back in the period if they turn it over to Paul Bryant on down. So interesting play call coming up here. And they got double tight ends.
Sweep it to the left side. Got the first down and more. That is Smith lowering a shoulder, taking it down close to the 5-yard line. Should be just inside the 6. It's going to be first and goal for the Lions. Definite power set. You see the way they line it up here. Austin Stevens, the linebacker, in there leading the way. And Smith just follows that wall of blockers. And now it's first and goal just outside the 6-yard line.
They went heavy, and it paid off.
Again, the shotgun look. Back to pass, throwing the fade pattern up, and too tall. The pressure that time coming in, as Harris unable to do anything, because as soon as he tried to set up, Kendarian Knight of Paul W. Bryant was right in his grill, and he could not step in to throw the football at all. The ball, as you see right there, good penetration and pressure from Knight, and just has to overthrow his receiver. So second down and goal for the Lions. Clock rolling, 4:02. As Harris will go from the shotgun. Again, four receivers. Smith to his right. Back is Harris, fade again. Shot is out there, and it is caught. Touchdown catch out here, and that is going to be James Jenkins. He'll pull it in, and we are tied up at 6 with 3:47 remaining in this period. Excellent thrown pass. There you see him hand jockey in there, and right at the last moment going up and bringing it in is James Jenkins. Great concentration to pull that one in, and we are tied at 6 apiece.
Big play for Mumford. That's what they needed to get into the end zone. Now with an extra point, or a 2-point conversion, to take the lead here with 3:47 to play in the quarter.
Looks like the Lions will go for two. Harris in the shotgun. Smith to his right. Fake it to Harris, to Smith. Now he's in trouble, going down. Defense that time with a big stop. You see number seven there, Brandon Benderson. Good-looking linebacker with a couple of good stops on that drive, and we are tied at six apiece. But the Munford Lions get on the board. Great pass and catch from Harris to Jenkins. 12 plays, 70 yards, eating 4:38 off the clock. And we are tied up at six apiece with 3:47 remaining. We'll see if Paul Bryant can answer here. Snyder with the shotgun look. We'll take the snap. We've got movement. And I believe it's going to cost the Stampede five. Lance Ford coming in motion there. Seemed to be the intended receiver. They were going to try to get a little screen action to him. Illegal procedure. Whistled against Paul W. Bryant. Moves it back. Makes it first down and 15. Tied up six apiece. Stampede football. Again, that quarterback, Reed Snyder. Good look at that young man there. They'll hand it off up the middle. Crooks hit in the backfield. Struggles forward. Back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe falling forward for a yard. It's going to bring up second, and we'll say 14 yards to go. Austin Stevens again on the stop. Very active middle linebacker. Snyder, snap, drops back, throws it on the outside, too tall. Dangerous pass that time, intended out here for Spencer. Coverage all around, but like you said, he just winds up and guns it. A little too tall, incomplete, brings up a third down, and about 14 to go. Clock rolling, 2:50 remaining here in this period. As Snyder drops back, throws it on the outside. The catch is made out here at the 35, 36-yard line. Looks to be shy of the first down, but a good catch out here by Spencer. As you see, once again, Snyder delivering the bullet, and it is caught out here by Spencer. Now you're looking at fourth down and about 3 yards to go. In a tie ball game, Paul W. Bryant says, we're going to go for it. Bunch set to the left side. Snyder calling out the signals. Munford almost entered the neutral zone, and this may be the tactic that the Stampede will try to get them to jump. And they will now burn their timeout. 2:06 remaining. Paul Bryant facing a fourth down and three. You would expect at this point to kick it away, but when we come back, we will find out. We are tied at six. It's Munford and Paul Bryant right here on the Gridiron Challenge on TV 24. 2:02 remaining here in this period. We are tied up at six. And as we anticipated, Paul Bryant elects to move the football forward with the punt, and Munford will have possession here and start at their 33-yard line.
I bet that was a tough call for Coach Hill, because really, he probably won't get the ball back. And he's probably thinking, you know, fourth and short, let's go for it, keep my offense on the field. But he would have given Munford a short field had he not made it.
Avery Harris in there at quarterback for the Lions.
Let's go, D!
As the Lions go right to left here with 1:52 remaining. Tied up at six. Harris drops back, throws the slant again. The catch is made by Elston. He's going to be hit at midfield, but will fall forward to the 45-yard line. Excellent throw and catch.
And now Coach Hill's probably thinking he should have gone for it, because after this throw and catch, Munford basically right back in the same area where they had the football.
Great throw that time. He put the ball on the money, catches Elston in stride. And now Munford with the football at the 45-yard line, a minute 43 remaining. Harris takes it, rolls out right, got pressure, throws into flats, too short. Pressure coming in that time. Jai Smith, the defensive end, a sophomore, 6'2", 214. It seems like every time we look at a Paul Bryant player making a play, they're sophomores. This is a relatively young team.
Yep, and that bodes well for the future of the program. And they've had some lean years, Tommy, as we've talked about. But looks like they've got some promising players in their future for the next couple of years.
Shotgun formation for Harris. He'll take it. Leave it on the left side. That's Smith. Smith breaks it back to the right, and he is going to be buried there. It's going to bring up a third down and long.
They're going to outscore Paul Bryant here in the next minute and a half and win the game. They're going to have to put it back in the air, so would not be surprised at all to see Avery Harris air it out here.
The defensive front for Paul Bryant has been strong here. Harris looks to the side. Clock rolling now with a minute seven remaining in this period. Takes the snap, throws it, going to be knocked down. That time, Harris looking for that slant again. And instead, the big paw of Dontarius Dukes able to get his hands up. They tell you if you can't get to the quarterback, get the hands up. And right now you see Dukes do exactly that. Great play. Knocking the football down. It's going to bring up fourth down and about 7 yards to go. And Munford with a decision right here. They're going to go for it with only 59 seconds left. Big play both sides. Back to pass as Harris got pressure, sets up the screen, too high, going to be picked off. Near side, far, here he goes to the races, 30, 25, 20, and taking it into the end zone for the Stampede is going to be Brian Moore, as that is an incredible change of events. The high throw, Moore reads it, picks it off, and outruns everybody into the end zone with a pick six. And now the Stampede go on top 12-6.
Play was read well by the Paul Bryant defensive backs. It looked for a moment like Mumford had the right play call because Paul Bryant was blitzing. If it had been a middle screen, Mumford would have scored. But instead, it was a screen out in the flats. The defensive backs read it perfectly. And there you go, touchdown.
And did you see the sideline go absolutely bonkers? You tell you, you say spring's not important. Paul Bryant realizes that they have got to set a foundation to build this program back up and get it started. That is a big play right there. If you're going to compete, you come out here to win the ball game. Snyder in for the two-point conversion. He'll step back, throw the slant catch, and it's in there. 14-0 on the slant to Moore. And Moore has been uncoverable here in these two periods.
So that breaks the tie, Tommy. You know, I know it may, you know, if you've ever played football or been a part of a football team or really any sports team, you know what it's like when you get on that school bus and you leave a game that you've won, especially on the road, and you travel home. It is a fun, festive bus ride, and Paul Bryant has a two-hour trip when they leave here, and unless something happens here in the next 48 seconds, they're going to be able to celebrate two wins tonight.
That's right. And it's like we said, I mean, if you play the game, you want to win the game. It doesn't matter if it's in May or in November, you want to come out on top. And this is really going to build a lot of confidence in this Paul Bryant team. But Munford with 48 seconds to see if they can make some magic happen. Harris drops back, throws it in the flats. The catch is made there, 35-yard line to the 39-yard line. Goes James Jenkins. He's got a touchdown pass reception a little bit earlier.
Mumford stops the clock here with 40 seconds, calling a timeout.
They will take the timeout, trailing 14-6. Lions need a touchdown and a two-point conversion after the gain of 9. It is second and a yard. You see Coach Bill Smith there as he's trying to get his troops rejuvenated here, trying to get something positive here to happen in the last 40 seconds.
I think he's still thinking about that screen return for a touchdown. Had his team was in good shape, had a chance to close out the game and win the game. But a defensive score by Paul Bryant. And now, again, like you say, Mumford is going to kind of take a little mini miracle here, Tommy. They've got the football at their own 39 with only 40 seconds to play. They're going to have to get it downfield in a hurry.
Yeah, I think you've got to look on the outside. Jenkins, a big play receiver, also Elston. Both of those young men can make something big happen if they can get on the outside and get in the open field. We'll see nothing but the pass, I would expect, here in the last 40 seconds because they've just used their only timeout of this period. Harris with Smith back behind him. He'll take it. Just as I say that, they give it off to Smith. He'll bounce it to the right side and got a gap. Midfield is Smith to the 45, to the 44-yard line. The clock will stop to move the chains as Smith bounces it outside for a big gain for Munford. So the Lions with a chance here as they will move it inside the 45 at about the 44-yard line, and they'll be at the line ready to snap as soon as the official gives them the okay. Harris, shotgun, takes it, drops back, looking, going to throw it deep. And coverage is down there. Great job on the outside by Jamarcus Burrell. Only a freshman defensive back as he will make the play there, and the coverage excellent on the outside.
But they do take a shot, and they may have to throw something. They don't want to throw over the middle of the field, and then you get a long gain over the middle of the field with no timeouts. That'll take a lot of the clock down, so I expect him to continue to throw those go routes or throw near the sideline.
Harris back, slant, catch, made. First down to the 30-yard line. Bounces off a defender inside the 30 to the 29. On the catch, there's Austin Campbell. It'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to move the chains. Munford will be back at the line of scrimmage again. This play earlier did not work. This time, Campbell climbs the ladder, pulls it in, and it's first down and 10 at the 29. So Munford with 12 seconds. You got two shots at the end zone here. As Harris with the shotgun look, three wideouts go to the right. They whistle it ready for play. Harris takes it, fakes the screen, now throws it on the outside, caught by Campbell, and he's going to be knocked out of bounds. Gain of only about three, but the clock is stopped with 6 seconds remaining in this period.
And probably, Tommy, one more play. That throwing to the sideline there enabled the receiver to get out of bounds and stop the clock. So you've got 6 seconds. Most likely, barring a defensive penalty, we're down to one more play for the Lions, and we've got an injured Paul Bryant player in the secondary down at the 10-yard line.
Yeah, I think he was injured before that play. That is Dorian Brooks, the defensive back, and he was trying to come off and could not get off the field before the play. And so now he is going to check out. But he had tried to come off the field, and Munford was ready to snap the football. They snap it, and now he's going to try to stay in. They're going to have to – the officials are telling him, nope, you got to come out, as he tries to stay on the field for this final play. 6 seconds remaining. And Harris will take one more shot at the end zone. Pressure coming, dropping back as Harris fakes it. Now he's throwing it intended in the end zone. It's overshot, and the clock stops with 1 second. So the Lions will get one more play here.
Boy, that's I think they get a break with the clock there. That play took seemingly more than 5 seconds, but they're going to get one more shot at it here from the 26-yard line.
See the coverage of Spencer there. Forcing this final play, 14-6. Paul Bryant up by 8. 1 second remaining.
And the fans that have remained here at JSU Stadium, Tommy, they're making some noise.
As it all comes down to this, three wideouts go to the right. Harris drops back, looking, throws the bubble screen, catch is made. That is Campbell trying to get outside. Cuts back, he's hit once, twice, and finally driven down. And Paul Bryant will come up with a stop and win this period. What a great, great game as Campbell could not get in the end zone. Little bubble screen out here. The catch is made. He tries to slip back inside. Needed a couple of blocks to be able to get to the outside and just couldn't get them. You see, as he cuts it back inside, the Paul Bryant defense swarms, and they will bring him down there and keep him out of the end zone. So that is how this one will end, 14-6. And as we said, look at the middle of the field. You don't think this is important to this team? They are jumping all over their coach, Eldrick Hill, as he gets two wins here tonight. Very impressive performance by both of those teams. John Holder is going to join us in just a moment with the coaches down on the field.
Yeah, Tommy, I'm with you. I'm impressed with both Paul Bryant and Munford. Munford coming up about 15 yards short of possibly tying this game at the as the clock ran out. But very well played quarter between these two teams.
Yeah, I think so. And as the coaches are getting together, you see John Holder, as he's got Coach Eldrick Hill out there, and we'll get him, and possibly Coach Bill Smith as well. We'll find out if we can corner him. We may get him after the final game. That's the way we're going to do it. Just only Coach Eldrick Hill at this point. So, John, we'll let you take it away, buddy. As we are, again, trying to get a word there. John having some audio difficulties there. Let's see if we can check it once again and make sure that we're okay down on the field and reset everything. John, you got us now?
All right, now we've got Eldrick Hill. We were talking earlier, and your guys had a lot of fun tonight. The fun is in the winning.
That's
talk
right.
about the
That's
fun
right.
you had tonight.
That's right. Hey, you know, I just took over this program last year, and prior to me getting there, they were 0-20. Last year we went 1-9 and lost a lot of close games, and I think we're ready to turn the corner this year.
What's it mean to these guys? I know it's a spring game, but when you've not won, to get to come in here and win like you've done tonight, this is big, isn't it?
That's right. It's very huge, and we appreciate Coach Felder for putting this on. We wanted to come out and get the kids in the College Stadium, great environment. You got scouts out here recruiting these kids, so it was well worth it.
Coach, have a fun trip. I'm sure you will back to Tuscaloosa. Thank you for coming up here to East Alabama.
Thank you guys for having us.
Eldrick Hill, head coach of the Paul Bryant Stampede, winners tonight here in Jacksonville.
Again. Happy birthday, Cole.
Happy birthday.
I like him, Tommy. Again, I mentioned I had spent some time with him during the weather delay. Just a, you know, I felt like I've already known him forever. He's the kind of guy who probably doesn't ever meet a stranger. But his enthusiasm tonight, if it carries over into the regular season, I think you're going to see a different type of Paul Bryant football program in the near future.
It is contagious, and a couple of wins here for the Stampede. They win this last matchup 14-6 over the Munford Lions. Football continues in a moment. It's Centerpoint and Munford coming up next on the Gridiron Challenge right here on TV 24.